I've made a copy of ODB54 and I made some changes to it. We're now going to allow the department and group fields to have null values. So if you're working along with me, you'll need to update your database. You can see how to do this from video 45. Or you can download the file ODB55Before from the website and work along with this video. What we're going to do in this video is add a wildcard search text box to the View by Department form that we created in the last two videos. This will allow us to type in all or part of the last name and include a department or leave either field blank and see the filtered results. The first thing we're going to do is add our new field to the filter table. So I'm coming over to Tables, right-clicking on Filter, the filter table, Edit, and we'll add in the last name. We'll leave the field type text varchar. Let's save this and close it. Going back into Forms, I'm going to right-click on ODB54, copy, paste. We'll call this ODB55 add wildcard. I'm going to right click on that and edit. We want to add in our new field, so I'm first going to open up the Form Navigator and select Form, then come down to Add Fields and double-click on the last name. We can see it's added in our Form Navigator, but we don't see it on the form. It's probably hidden behind our subform. I'll select that and delete it. There's our last name. Let's undo that delete. Now I'm going to select the last name and the label for that last name. Come over to the form and click on the form to give that focus. Then hold down my arrow up and bring in the last name. I'm going to hold down Control and click on the last name label to bring that above the last name text box and select them both and move it up even with the department ID. Now we're going to click on the subform. Right-click and open up the properties. I'm going over to the form properties and we're going to change table to an SQL command. And our content is going to be some SQL. Our SQL is going to look like this. We've got select asterisk from table employees where, and then in our department ID equals colon, then a variable name. And we talked about this in video 27, user parameters. This would allow us to type in a user parameter. This or, then our variable name is null, allows us to put a null and not force it to have to be null. We allow all values. If you have questions on how this works, just take off that or and you'll see why we need that. Then for our last name, we've got our percent sign. If we type in the letter L, it will find L either at the beginning, the end, or anywhere in the middle. The upper switches everything to uppercase. It will find any version of the L, uppercase or lowercase. Let's select this SQL. Copy. Now we're going to change our content type to SQL command and paste in our SQL. Now we're going to come down to our linked fields. We want the department ID, then I'm going to hold down Shift, Enter, and we want it to be department ID and last name. I'm hitting Enter there. Then for our next one, we're going to change department ID to be that variable name from our SQL, which was VAR for variable, underscore DPT for department, Shift, Enter, VAR underscore LN for last name. That should be a capital T. Now we should be all set. I'm going to save the form and go into Design View. We see the manufacturing. If I refresh it, we'll change this to management, refresh. Go into IT, refresh. Now let's add in a last name. Let's find all the last names with an I in it. An I and in IT. Refresh. There we go. Right, Martinez, Smith, Robinson, Lewis, and Hill. Let's change this to an uppercase H. Refresh. We get Hill, Smith, and Wright. Let's change our department to be nulls. And this is why I needed to add nulls to our department field. Otherwise, I would not have this null field up at the top of our drop-down box. Refresh. All the last names with H. Let's just type in Sun. Refresh. Got Anderson, Robinson, Thompson, Jackson, and Johnson. Our view employee by department is working just the way we want.